Whoa.
Whoa.
That was cool. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the lab. I'm Grant Thompson, the King of Random.
And I'm Derek from the YouTube channel Veritasium.
And today we are playing with fire and ice. I just got back from the gas station where I picked up this bag of ice, but this is no ordinary bag of ice. You see, when we pour this ice into a bowl and light it off with a torch, you can see that the ice burns. Why is that? So we're gonna come clean, guys. This bowl wasn't completely empty when we dumped in the ice. I first sprinkled on a fine layer of a chemical called calcium carbide.
CaC2.
Now this calcium carbide, I just went down to a chemical supply store and picked up for about $56, but this stuff's actually been used for centuries. Originally, it was used in miners' lamps. They would put it in, add a little bit of water, and it would pump out acetylene gas that they could light, and that's how they would light their way in the mines. Funny enough, calcium carbide, its main purpose today is to still produce acetylene gas. And when you mix acetylene with oxygen, it produces one of the hottest flames, burning around 3,500 degrees Celsius, which is ridiculous.
That is really hot. That's hardcore.
If we pour some of the actual calcium carbide out here, you can see what it looks like. They almost look like little grayish black granules of rock. Not super exciting until they make contact with water. The instant this stuff touches water, it starts releasing this misty white vapor, which is extremely flammable. And as we've just experienced, as soon as it's lit, it's a very, very hot flame. I mean, we could feel this from quite a distance.
Yeah, yeah.
We just lit ice on fire. That's really cool. Let's talk about that for a second.
I actually have a little molecule kit. Should I bring it over here? So the calcium carbide has two major components, obviously your calcium and your C2, and they're triple bonded. These are carbons that are triple bonded. If you add in some water, what ends up happening is they break apart the calcium off of there and you form calcium hydroxide, which is CaOH2, like that. And then the hydrogens end up going on there and that creates your acetylene gas, also known as ethine. And this is the very flammable stuff that reacts with oxygen and creates a very, very hot flame. That is an amazing reaction. What I think is so cool about it, right, is that when you do it on ice, you start it with just a little bit of water, so you just get this reaction starting, get a little bit of acetylene, but then, of course, once the fire kicks in, melt more ice, create more water, that furthers the reaction, producing more acetylene.
And it's like a self-feeding cycle.
Exactly.
What I find is really interesting, and I'm not sure what exactly is going on here, but look at all the soot. Look at all this black residue right here. And we've got little chunks floating around in the air. And what's really interesting is we just had this calcium carbide and ice, like nothing else went into it. And now we're left with bubbles. And what an interesting smell. Did you smell the gas coming off as well?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, it's not quite the smell of rotten eggs. It smells a little bit different, but I would put it in the same family, the same category.
It's a little bit like gunpowder.
Yes.
A little bit of a smell like that.
Yeah, almost like a burned rotten egg smell.
Yeah.
For sure. But very, very flammable. Who knows what that would do to your body? Something super, I'm sure.
Well, it's basic, right? So it would dissolve a lot of things. It would dissolve your flesh.
Yes. Calcium carbide is pretty cool, but one of the things that's made me wonder is where does it come from? How is it made? And as I did a little bit of research, what I found is in an industrial process, they actually use an arc furnace with carbon rods and take coke and lime and burn it together at very high temperatures, around 2200 degrees Celsius.
So you could probably do that with your backyard foundry, right?
Well, maybe not the backyard foundry, but I do have a mini arc furnace, which is basically the same thing on a smaller scale. So I wonder, could we produce calcium carbide? That might be an experiment for another day. So there you have it, guys. Now you know how to use a little bit of calcium carbide
to make fire on ice,
which is a very cool experiment. Very, very messy, very, very dangerous, but very, very cool. Thanks so much for joining us for this experiment, guys. Huge thanks to Derek with Veritasium for bringing out his models and showing us the science behind why this works. You can go check him out. I've got a link down in the description, and I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. Easier than animating 3D models.
Yeah.
So there you go, guys. Now you know how to use a little bit of calcium carbide mixed with ice.
That's the vehicles coming back. Sorry.
So there you have it, guys. Now you know how to...
Son of a bitch.
Hey, guys. I wanted to jump back in for just a second to invite you to come follow me on Instagram. I've got a very active page where I post daily pictures and stories of behind the scenes and every day is an adventure. Just take 5 seconds right now to click the link in the description to come follow me on Instagram at thekingofrandom, and I'll see you there.